Hello and welcome to the Vector Garden YouTube channel. My name is Monika and in this video we're going to take a look at three ways to create this kind of pattern. So it's very regular. It has these squares that become smaller as they go to the center. And we have three ways. Two of them are rather precise. One of them is not precise, and of the two precise ways, one is quick and editable and the other is a little slower but built into Illustrator. Okay, all of these get started with this shape, and the shape has an inner glow applied. Let's take a look at the appearance panel, and there is the inner glow, and this is set to black and blending mode normal to get this gradient. And then what we're going to do, I'm going to make a copy. And for the first thing, we need to rasterize this. And I'm going to object rasterize, and 150 ppi is more than enough. So let's just go ahead with it. And now this needs to be converted into a very special kind of vectorization. And for this to work, we're going to object create object mosaic, and you enter the number of tiles that you want to have, and we're going with 100, and then you use the ratio so the other value gets adjusted, and Illustrator will then create all the tiles. And since this takes a certain amount of time, I'm not going to do it here. What you need to do is just click on OK and you can delete the raster. So the original raster image will be deleted. I'm going to cancel that here because I've already done it, and this is the result you're going to get. Let's go into the outline view, which looks like this. So we need to clean this up, and this needs to be ungrouped. Let's do that. Select one of the white ones and then go to select same appearance, and all the white ones get selected, and let's delete them. So we are left with this. And what we're now going to do is scale these based on their lightness. And for this, you can get a script, and I'm going to put the link into the comments, just going to show you that, which is this GitHub, and you can download the whole amount of scripts here, and the one you need is the size by luminance. I've already downloaded it, and what you need to do is select an amount of these. Don't try to do them all at once because then Illustrator will likely crash. So maybe like this, and then you go to File, Scripts, and wherever you have installed it, I'm going to go to Other Script, and there it is. And then just run it. And in this case, you have to click on no because they are viewed on a light background. The script will now take some time to run through all these elements and scale them. So let's just wait for it to happen. These are already a few hundred of elements, and it will take some time. So there we have the result, and I'm going to show you that. So you see they don't have all the same color. They have just kept their color, and we'll have to adjust that later. So what you now do is select all of them and then go to lock the selection, and then you're going to select the next number of tiles and scale them as well. And in the end, you will have all these scaled squares, and then what you can do is select them all and apply the color you want to have. So that is the first method, which takes some time because the mosaic needs to run and the script needs to run, and the result is precise. So the next thing you can do is take the base element again. So let's make another copy, and then I'm going to delete the stroke from it like so, and then let's apply a different effect. In this case, we're going to apply color halftone, and we want to have a pure black and white result, and that's why I'm setting all of these to the same amount, and because I want to have these squares just horizontally and vertically, I'm going to set them all to zero. And with this amount, you set the size of the circles. So let's get to OK. And this is what you get. So this is the result, but it's a pixel-based element now. So what we need to do is auto trace it. For that, because it's a live effect, we're first going to Object and then Expand Appearance. The result is based on the document raster effect settings, which is set to 300 ppi. You can set that higher, of course. And now what we're going to do is open the image trace and then have it auto traced. So let's select the black and white, and you see this is very chaotic, and we can set this to high and set the corners to less. And when you set a lower noise, then you get more of these small circles, but still some of them are not really circles. So, but since we need squares anyway, that doesn't matter a lot. So let's close this and expand the trace. And what I didn't do, and I'm going to revert that. So let's get to the image trace again, and I'm going to check ignore white like so, and then let's expand it so we don't have any white pixels in here, and then ungroup this thing so we have all single elements, so like so, and then select them all, go to Effect, Convert to Shape, Rectangle, and set these to 0 and 0, like so. And you see, there we have the result, but it's not precise. These should be smaller than this, but it's not. So this just works if precision is not your main objective. So let's get to the third method, and for this you need a plugin. The plugin is called Phantasm by Astute Graphics, and the link will also be in the comments of this. So let's go to Effect, Phantasm, Halftone, and then we can select a square in here, and then of course set the DPI. So let's make a higher DPI in order to get smaller squares. And you can also scale them slightly so you get a larger gap between them, like so, and then go to OK and let's take a look at it. So this is a precise result. It's quick and it's even editable. So let's go to Window, Appearance, and there we have the halftone effect, so we can go into it later and adjust it. So these were three methods to create this kind of pattern for your objects. If you liked the video, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. See you next time.